Melanie Windridge says, any thoughts on fusion energy? I saw a tweet of yours about the old joke about fusion being always 30 years away. I think that I'm actually quite excited about fusion energy at the moment. Now, this might sound brave, given that fusion energy has been promising us something for a long time and has never delivered, and it's always 40 years away or 30 years away. But actually, what's happened in the last few years is that thanks to high-temperature superconductors, a lot of private sector operators have moved into the fusion space and started building spherical tokamaks as opposed to donut-shaped tokamaks and other such innovations. And these are resulting in really rapid progress towards the goal of stable, sustainable fusion output from a fusion reactor. They've got to get to a certain magnetic field strength, they've got to get to a certain temperature, and they've got to make the plasma stable at those temperatures, and then they can start to make energy out of the fusion of hydrogen atoms. I say in the book that I think this technology will come in my lifetime. Now, that might be wrong, but if it did, just imagine what it would be like from an object the size of a small room, smaller than that, object the size of a large piece of furniture. We might be able to generate enough electricity to power a town and to do so indefinitely. And the fuel would effectively be water. I mean, you have to make tritium and so on, but this would be an incredible opportunity. But the one way to stop it happening would be to subject fusion to the same incredibly onerous regulation that we have subjected fission to. That is what has prevented the process of fission innovation.